Thank you, everyone, for having me. And what an amazing buzz this whole day so far has been. Just listening to everyone talking is fantastic. Before I start, I'd like to acknowledge the traditional custodians of owners of the land and elders past, present and future. There are things that I've heard today that Jeff's comment about the heroes in the room, you're all heroes. The students, Jodie, Erica and Claire, what you shared was amazing. And other comments like birth certificates, immunisation, leaving out of home care. My role in the Department of Human Services, which is under the Centrelink banner, is grandparent advisor. It came into play in 2010, launched by Tanya Plibersek, who was the minister at the time, in recognition of all of the people that were caring for children that were not their own. The title itself is a bit confusing for our foster carers and kinship carers because we service, there are eight of us. We started with six, and I used to service Victoria and Tasmania. We now have eight, and our in every state, including Tasmania and the Northern Territory. We are still called grandparent advisors, but we service a 1-800 number, so it doesn't matter where you are in Australia, you would call the same number, and you would just be going through to the person in that state. It is not like a call centre environment. It actually goes straight to my desk. If people are calling me today, it will go to a message bank, but also my team nationally have chosen today to take all of those calls off and get those calls answered today. At times, because my role is community-based as well, when calling that 1-800 number, you would leave a message. And I endeavour to get back to you within two working days. We've been able to bring that back into line that we are about a day and a half out, and at different times through starting this role, it has blown out to be 4 days out. The ever-growing out-of-home care is incredible, and I seriously tip my hat to all of you. I wanted to share some of the things in relation to different payment types. All our payment types are income tested, except for our carer's allowance. I often get an inquiry about the state government carer payment and or Department of Health and Human Services have advised them to call me to find out about our carer payment. Our carer payment and carer allowance. Carer payment is like a pension, it is income and asset tested and it requires a medical report to be completed. Many of our children in these circumstances are, and as we've heard from other speakers today, traumatised and therefore there is potential. It's not always, doesn't always have to be a recognised disability. But it's also, there is not everyone, it's not carte blanche that because you're caring for a child that is not your own that you're going to qualify for carer payment. Carer allowance is an add-on payment to that. It is not asset tested or income tested, but it still requires the medical report to be completed. I speak to many families where children are linked to paediatricians, psychologists, psychiatrists, and the list can go on. You would like to potentially choose the person that is going to recognise all of the issues that the child is going through. Formal care. So formal care is potentially when a court order, whether it be family court, child protection, have placed the child in your care. What frightens me a lot is how many people I speak to who child protection have been involved, but they are closing the case. It is leaving our carers with no state government assistance, and it is also potentially leaving them in a very difficult state in regards to getting qualified for any form of assistance through ourselves. We look at that as informal care. Now, people who are in formal care placement often don't even make an inquiry, but they should, because we have mechanisms in place to be able to recognise that you are the primary carer of the child. We would ask for evidence of care. Every claimant or recipient requires to provide us evidence of care. If it is a formal arrangement, we ask for a letter on Department of Health and Human Services letterhead confirming the date of the placement. We receive many different types of letters, sometimes asking for special childcare benefit, but we really need child's date of birth, child's name, carer's name and address, whether it's a court order or not, and the start date of that care. I've spoken to many carers who may have had the child in their care for over a year and not ever even understood that my role existed as part of an information pack or anything like that. We have family tax benefit. We have that is income tested. It's based on estimated income. We have childcare benefit and there is childcare rebate. I get a lot of inquiry from foster carers about the childcare rebate. Unfortunately, unless you are meeting the work training study test for childcare rebate, foster carers do not automatically qualify for childcare rebate. Quite often, child protection may request that we pay childcare rebate to reduce the bill even further, but foster care is not deemed to be a voluntary participation because foster carers actually have a choice versus grandparent carer or relative carer. Foster carers are putting themselves forward to be foster carers and there are many other financial supports. We have Medicare. Medicare is a big issue in the sense that many of our carers don't have the Medicare card. If a child is known to Centrelink, they're not required to provide a birth certificate, but our online claim will ask you for one. So we have that problem with our brand new babies who may be removed from birth. You can have your Medicare card, the child's Medicare card copied and transferred to your own, but a lot of the time if the child is known, we are also aware of the immunisation details and we can go ahead with the childcare benefit claim. I'm aware my time is seriously running out. The telephone number and in your show bags there is a fact sheet that gives you the 1-800 number. I have met a few people in the room today that I have spoken to in the past. For any of you that may never have known my role exists, please give me a call. Please, so we can check and do a quality check on your record, even if you are receiving something from Centrelink already. Any child that is in care that is not your biological child is entitled to a non-income tested healthcare card, and it's called a foster care healthcare card. So many of our customers or recipients or people that are wanting to claim may self-assess and say, well, I'm not a foster carer. But that is something that every family should have. Some families will qualify for an automatic healthcare card or pension card because our payments are mainly income tested. So the purpose of our role is to ensure that you are getting the right information, as a lot of feedback can be received that you are not necessarily receiving the right information when you may enter our front of house environment. And so please contact through the 1-800 number if you have further queries beyond today. And I will close it up there because I'm very mindful of having to pick school children up or getting yourselves home out of the city. So thank you very much.